Hey, how's everybody? Everybody good?
Yeah.
Ah, thanks, John Paul. Y'all are a well-heeled crowd tonight. I'm really glad to be here. And I'm honored to be the performer here among such a great lineup of speakers. When I was thinking about what I was going to say, because he said I could talk before I performed, and I'll get to that. I wrote like several long things over the last month or so, just wondering what I was going to say. And then I was sitting over there earlier, and he said that the theme was ripples, which honestly, y'all, I really should have known. but I didn't. And so what I think I'll say is that I'm here because of a ripple, actually, a TED Talk ripple. I'm here really because of Brene Brown's TED Talks. There's a couple online you can find about the power of shame and the power of vulnerability. And some of those ideas really did change my life. One of them, like the power of shame, owning our shames, talking about them, not holding back, being real, that kind of thing, allowed me to get up on a stage for the first time and say, and y'all, I'm 26, about to be 27. By the time I was 20 and 21, I was like a full-blown drunk, like bags of garbage in my living room, cockroaches everywhere on Southside. Nobody could come in that place. It's a really dark story. After that, I started eating because I still couldn't deal with stuff in my life, even though I had quit drinking, which didn't take the first time. It took several times. I started eating and I gained like 115 pounds. I weighed like 220 pounds. This little body up here. Anyways, because of that idea of owning our shames, those are really not a huge deal for me to talk about in front of people because I talk about them so often. I'm a little more wary of telling y'all that like I've been so nervous about being up here talking. I don't mind performing, but talking is different. That I've been stress eating for like 2 weeks. Like I was in the drive-thru of Taco Bell yesterday, getting those cinnamon twists. Anybody have any cinnamon twists? Those crunchy, yeah? Those crunchy cinnamon delicious things. Just hanging out with this guy I'm crushing on. He'd go in the kitchen, I was in the living room, and I just, real quick, when he was over there. So he didn't even see. That kind of stuff is what I'm gonna perform about. Because I've noticed since I started trying to live Brene Brown's ideas, that I don't have to be ashamed of who I am or what I've done. That I can be vulnerable, that I can be open and share and connect with people every single day. It really did change my life. It's the hardest thing I've ever done. I don't really recommend it yet. But it's where this piece comes from. This piece is called There's More to Our Stories. And it goes a little something like this. There's more. I forgot, y'all. I'm gonna say thank you when I'm done, so there's not that awkward, like, is she done? Silence, right? Okay. Let me try again. There's more. Y'all, there is more to y'all's stories. What are y'all hoarding behind those blue, brown, green eyes to say, you're fine, oh, you're fine? Towing a line of lies so high, I have to give it time before I reply. Feeling behind those eyelids down deep. Throwing me steep curveballs that I'm barely batting away with my eyelashes and flashes of, we can do better than this. Because I'll be real if you'll just feel with me now how the darkness comes in blue-black, cracking bones in my back that spread across the windshield of tonight feel like fighting. Sometimes I'm so mad that life is sad and hard and messy. Is this a confession? Do I get to be the one to confess the sins of our foremothers and fabulous fathers? Or would y'all rather me rhyme about the time that I got stuck, almost gave up, and needed more than luck to pull me up? Because y'all, if it's easier, I'll go first. The worst part is beginning, really. The worst part are the words we don't want to say, leaving out most of our story, but life is boring. If I don't know you, and you don't know me, or you hold back building tall walls, asking me to ascend the bricks and mortar that make you immortal, I'll hold you up to a portal where we both can dance, where we start a romance of revolution, where we say what we think, even if it stinks sometimes. Because y'all, I mean, we all got lives of strife and woe and put on a show for the world that isn't really watching. But I'm watching. I was near then, and I'm here now. My heartbeat on this stage telling me the page I need to write to start y'all sparks, because sometimes y'all, I still get stuck. I give up, and I'm gonna ask y'all to pull me up. And we can start today. Tell me it's okay. Thank you.